whenever we are discussing about biology, actually we are having knowledge of God. Rather, I should say knowledge of organism, because every time whenever we are discussing this organic or say biological part, you will find that the fantastic mechanism is made, and this mechanism generated automatically. Best example we can say, suppose you have a car. That car can be repaired again and again, but that car will not give rise to another car. Don't ask me that I can exchange out, that is different. But from one car, another same to same car is not generated automatically. But from one animal, the similar animal is generated automatically. So this is fantastic mechanism present over here. Now, whenever we are discussing out biology, we are discussing out various systems. Now let us talk of human body. And we are now concentrating more on human body and the systems present in human body. Now, externally, our body is covered by a part that is called as exoskeleton. It is made up of hairs. Then skin is present, and inside skin, different organs are present. These organs may work independently or may be connected with other organs. So whenever these organs are working independently, they are simply, we can call them as organ. But if they are working with system, that means other organs or other part is there, then we are calling that as system. Now this system we have to discuss, say for example, respiratory system, then digestive system, excretory system, reproductive system, nervous system, hormonal coordination, that the system of endocrine gland, and variety of things we have to discuss. Now today we are going to discuss just basics, because many terms are not clear in our school days, and so we are going to discuss these terms first, and then we will start the actual function. Just now we have discussed about hormone. Then many times in biology we are hearing word enzyme. Exactly what is the role? Say in case of chemical reaction we have discussed about catalyst. So somewhat similar role is there for this enzyme or hormone. Now enzyme or hormone, they are made up of proteins only. Enzymes are having specific action at specific location. Hormones are also having specific action, but hormones are produced in some different part of body and just spread all over the body. Let us make this point clear. There is one enzyme, for example, trypsinogen or pepsinogen. Now these are secreted in digestive system, and their impact is there in digestive system only. So the impact is at a situation, or say for example, another enzyme is there, that is amylase, salivary amylase. Let us take name as salivary amylase. So it is secreted in our mouth part. From salivary gland it is secreted. The role is digestion of carbohydrate, and it is carried out in, whereas hormones are secreted from gland. That glands are called as endocrine gland. They are ductless gland. They are just released in blood, and these hormones are having impact at different locations. Say for example, pituitary gland is present. It is in the center part of brain, that center part of our head. Below that brain part, one gland is present, that is called as pituitary gland. It is releasing out certain hormones, say for example TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone. The impact of that thyroid stimulating hormone is on thyroid gland, which is situated over here. So this way, the impact of hormone is at different location, gland is situated at different location. So hormone and enzyme, both are the chemicals which work, which trigger out the reaction. You are aware, when revolver is there, there is trigger. Just trigger out, means start out the process. So enzyme and hormones, they are having somewhat similar function, but the mode of action, or say the generation and action place, are different over there. Now whenever we are discussing out biology, we are hearing out the word carbohydrate, protein, fat. All these are biomolecules, the molecules which are required to keep biological system in intact position. Now these biomolecules, they are ultimately have basic components as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. So whether it is carbohydrate, fat, protein, they should have out of this composition. Say for example carbohydrate, can you name one of the carbohydrate as we had discussed earlier? Try to recollect. This is C6H12. So this is having CH and O. Whereas when proteins are there, the nitrogen is also introduced over there. You are aware of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is having presence of iron. So apart from this CH, O and N, other elements are also present. For example, iron, then you are aware in chlorophyll, magnesium is present, and like that other elements are also present over here. So this will indicate that what is the nature. So technically speaking, carbohydrates are made up of only carbon, hydrogen and oxygen over here. But these carbohydrates, fat and protein, they have different composition. We are not going in detail of that. Only thing we should understand that three basic, or basic means fundamental things, carbohydrate, fat and protein, they have their important duties. Say for example, carbohydrates are used as source of energy. So fundamental function of carbohydrate is that source of energy. That carbohydrates are consumed, they are oxidized by different hormone, enzyme, they are oxidized, and ultimately energy is generated from that, energy is released from that, and that energy is utilized by our body. So role of carbohydrate is basically to generate energy and keep the system energy rich. Fat is acting as reserve source of energy. So extra material or extra food that is stored in form of fat, the role number one, the most important role, that fat that is having role of reserve food. Then certain compounds, as we have discussed, they are not soluble in water. Say for example in organic photosynthetic part, we have discussed carotenoids are there. These carotenoids are not soluble in water, but they are soluble in fat. So like that, many compounds are there. One of the carotenoid that we have discussed, beta carotene, that is not soluble in water but soluble in fat. Vitamin A, which is generated from beta carotene. Beta carotene is called as precursor of vitamin A. So vitamin A is also fat soluble. Vitamin D, fat soluble, not water soluble. Whereas vitamin B, vitamin C, these are example of fat, water soluble. So like that, if compounds are not water soluble but they are fat soluble, then fat in our body is used as solvent for that. Then various joints are present in our body, so use of fat is there, that is called as synovial fluid. So in synovial fluid, these fats are used, these are fats are acting as lubricant over there. So variety of uses are there, but basic use, fundamental use of fat, that is a reserve food material. Then you are aware that on the skin, certain glands are there, they are called as sebaceous gland. They are secreting out oily secretion. This oily secretion is spread over the skin, so skin will rinse. Fundamental role of protein, that is the body making. whatever our body is there, that body is made up of proteins only. So like whenever we are constructing out a building, for that purpose building material is required, that is bricks, cement, or like that material is required. So that material is for our body, that is of protein. Various chemicals, we are calling them as enzyme, we are calling them as hormone or whatsoever. These chemicals are made up of protein. So proteins are playing very, very important role in our body. Say whatever we have discussed about vitamins, these vitamins are also proteins only. Now these proteins are having nitrogen. So carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen, that is also there. Then hemoglobin, as we have discussed, that is also name of protein only, which is having iron. Whereas chlorophyll, that is having magnesium. So like that, proteins are composed of variety of things, but basically C, H, O and N, that is the common over there. Now, role of protein, that as we have discussed, bodybuilding material, the fundamental role. Second role, that variety of chemicals are produced in body, they are made up of proteins only. Third thing, important thing, that whenever there is absence of carbohydrate or deficiency of carbohydrate for energy, then fat is used. But if fat is also consumed, then ultimate source of energy for body, that is the protein. So variety of actions of proteins are there. Now these are all bodybuilding material. Or survival of organism, these chemicals are essential. Now they are playing certain important roles, as we have discussed. They are generated, say for example, carbohydrate, that is generated from photosynthesis process. But whenever digestion process is there, all carbohydrates, whatever the carbohydrates we are consuming, whether it is starch or other carbohydrate, then they are just broken down into glucose form. As we have discussed, starch, that is called as polymer, that is unit is repeated, so that is called as actually polysaccharide, that is hydrolyzed to monosaccharide, that is glucose, and then it is absorbed by our body. Whereas proteins, whatsoever proteins are there, they are digested as amino acids, and these amino acids are absorbed by our body, and they are, say for example, if I have to construct a building, for that purpose bricks are required. I am having abundant soil. That soil I am not able to use directly. I have to filter it out. Then whatever the fine particles are there, that can be used for making of bricks. Whatever fine particles are not there, either I should have crusher that I should convert it into fine particle, or simply discard it and take new. I have to prepare bricks of that. And from that bricks, using proper sequence, I have to produce a building. So same way, whatever we are consuming, that is in form of protein, raw material, that is crushed down in form of amino acids in our body. Then it is absorbed, and these molecules of amino acids are synthesized again to get desired proteins. This is the way mechanism works. Now, this is about the list of chemicals which are essential. Then other thing, that water, obviously water plays important role, inorganic part, but very, very vital role, important role is played by water. Now we have to discuss about various systems. Then there is coordination of the system in our body. So henceforth we are starting our discussion, basically we are concentrating on human body first, then we'll discuss about other part of biology. Let us start. Now, digestive system is having different organs. Few organs are indirectly connected organs also. It starts from mouth and ends in anus. So first part, that is mouth, we are going to discuss. Then esophagus, then stomach, intestine, small intestine obviously, then large intestine, rectum, anus. This is path. This path is called as alimentary canal. It is associated with certain glands which are associated with it. For example, pancreas, liver, then salivary gland. These glands are associated with it. Now, let us start the digestion process. What is digestion? It is breaking down of complex substances into simpler substance, and then it is absorbed. So, conversion of complex substances into simple substances, that is called as digestion. As we have discussed in photosynthesis, the food is produced. That means solar energy is trapped, and complex substances are produced from simple substances. So that's why energy enters in them. Now, this is the way that they are called as producers. But remaining all categories, whether they are scavengers, primary consumers or secondary consumers, they are getting energy from these producers. Now, the producers are called as autotrophic mode. The nutrition mode, that is called as autotrophic mode of nutrition. Whereas, the remaining categories, they are all heterotrophic. Now, heterotrophic are also divided into two parts. One is called as saprophytic, and another one is called as holozoic. So, nutrition, I can classify nutrition in two ways, that is autotrophic mode and heterotrophic mode. Autotrophic mode, they are only producers, whereas photosynthetic or chemosynthetic, but we are not going in detail. So only we are going till autotrophic mode. The heterotrophic mode, this is divided into further as saprophytic and holozoic. What is the meaning of saprophytic and holozoic? Case of saprophytic, the food is digested outside the body and it is absorbed. Like in case of fungus, certain enzymes are coming over there, the food is broken down into simpler part and it is absorbed. In case of bacteria also, this type of action is there. Then these actions are called as saprophytic action. Holozoic, the food is consumed, taken inside the body, then it is digested and absorbed. Unabsorbed portion is thrown away. So this is the mode of nutrition. So simpler way we can call this as holozoic. So in case of man, we have to think of holozoic type of nutrition. Reason is that we are taking food inside the body and it is used. Suppose in hospital, many times we are giving saline. That actually we are calling saline, but that is not saline. That is the solution of glucose. Dextrose, actually we are saying that dextrose solution is there along with certain salt, and many times pre-digested part also given. So whatever, say for example, we are giving simple saline, that is glucose we are giving, that is somewhat like saprophytic. That pre-digested food directly entering in blood. But this is in rare case and artificial. Otherwise, in case of man, we are using only holozoic technique. That food is directly taken in, then it is digested. Now, digestion process involves various stages, or simply this nutrition. Nutrition involves various stages. The first stage of this is called as ingestion. Don't call it injection. This is called as ingestion. That food is taken in. The second stage, that is digestion. The complex substance, they are converted into simpler substance. Then after that, absorption. The whatever digested food is there, that is absorbed from alimentary canal. So this is the absorption. After absorption, we have to use the absorbed material. The use of absorbed material is called as assimilation. Suppose a person consumes potato. Potato contains large amount of starch. So that starch is polysaccharide, that is digested, absorbed in form of glucose. Then that glucose is used for making energy. We are calling that as assimilation. Or that glucose is converted into another polymer, that is called as glycogen, that is also assimilation. So assimilation means whatever the part we are consuming out, they are converted into our body part or they are used by our body, then that is assimilation. Lastly, egestion, that is the whatever food is absorbed, that is unwanted material is remaining, that is thrown away out of the body. But consider here this part, that it is different from excretion. In case of excretion, the assimilated part, the part of our body, that is converted into waste material and that is thrown away of the body. Whereas in this egestion case, whatever substance we are consuming out, the required thing is absorbed, unwanted thing is thrown away. So that is the basic difference here in case of excretion and egestion. But many times the excretory products are released in this alimentary canal. The digestion process starts from our mouth. So we have to take account of our mouth first. Whenever a person consumes food, the first thing that before consumption also, a digestion process may begin. For example, you are very, very hungry and the food which is very, very favorite, that is there in front of you, the saliva start coming in mouth. The same way enzymes start coming over there, or many times at particular time these processes can be carried out. The role of vision is also important, because by observing that particular object we decide that whether it is good for consumption or not. Then smell, for general people smell is also important, because some exceptional cases they don't have sense of smell. So I expect that general people's sense of smell is important, because of that smell we decide that food is good or not, and whether it is consumable. If it is consumable, then whether it is favorite for you or not, like that. So these all are acting as accessory. But once the food enters in our mouth, the fundamental thing, that is mechanical crushing down of food, that is carried out. In chemical kinetics we have discussed, the rate of reaction depends on particle size. As particle size is smaller, rate of reaction is high. As particle size is smaller, the reagents require in less quantity also, because reaction completes in fast period. So we are discussing this. So mechanical crushing is very, very important, that is achieved by our mouth. In mouth, teeth, they are present, the hard portion of bone, they are responsible for the crushing down. Now just take account of that. Here four front teeth, lower jaw and upper jaw, total 8, they are called as incisors. So keep in mind scissor, incisor, they are having role, bite, cutting down. So this is first part, that if object is hard, that is simply first cut down by incisor, then only it is allowed to enter in mouth. Then here 2 and here 2, total 4 canines are present. We discuss in that history part, that is the primitive man or ape. What is difference between ape and man? At that time we have discussed the canines, they are having broader base and pointed at top, so they can apply more force, or rather we should say more pressure, and therefore the hard substance that can be converted, that can be break down very easily, mechanical breaking is carried out by canines. Then here 2 and upward 2, so that means 4, and 4 on this side, 8, they are called as premolars. So total, as we have discussed, that there are 8 incisors, then 4 canines, again 8, they are called as premolar, then 8 molar. Premolars are having somewhat smaller size than molars, whereas molars, they are having broad base and broad size. So these 8 molars, the 2 on this side, 2 upside, here 2 and here 2, 8 molars are present. Just carry out total 8, 16, 4, 20, 28. So for normal man, the number of teeth present there are 28. Plus we have to add 4. They are called as wisdom tooth. Obviously, at age of 20, for many people only 28 is the number. After certain age, after maturity, that means more we can say, as age increases, maturity also increases, and therefore they are called as wisdom tooth. So 4 wisdom tooth are present, may be present, may not be present, but total number, the maximum number is present as 32. Now why this wisdom tooth? We don't know exactly, because many times they give trouble. The practical use of wisdom tooth is not possible, because this is at end of our jaw. So this is the bite. This is the jaw. Here we are having incisors at beginning. So here the moment is high. So upper jaw will remain as it is only. We have to move like this. But here, this is the wisdom tooth. So here practical movement is very, very less, and therefore the much of the work is not carried out by this. Whereas molars, they can carry out this type of work, because here the practical movement is high. So anyway, this food is crushed down finely in the mouth portion with help of a muscular organ present, that is tongue, that will move here and there. And the whatever consumed food, that is converted into fine paste. Saliva is mixed over there. The important function, what is the carried out in mouth, that is the mechanical crushing of food, the mixing of saliva, and what is the most important, that fine paste is formed. Then this is entering in the body. Unless and until a desired particle size is not obtained, the food is not entering inside the body. And therefore, whatever food we are consuming, that is make soft, and then it is converted into fine paste, then it is entering in the body through a duct. This duct is called as esophagus. Spelling starts with O. Don't pronounce as oesophagus. This is esophagus. This is a tube, as we have discussed in the respiratory part. This is trachea, whereas this is esophagus tube, and one covering lid is present over there that will open. Say for example, this will close, then esophagus will open. Suppose this is on esophagus, then trachea will open. So at a time one can consume food, one can swallow food, or one can respirate. Both things are not carried out simultaneously. So this esophagus, the food particles, they are now entering over here. Now just observe, diameter of esophagus is small, whereas the swallowed food, that is having somewhat bigger diameter, but that enters in the esophagus, and some sort of this action. This is the part of consumed food. The force is applied over here, and this is sent to the downward part. This action in esophagus is called as peristalsis. What is peristalsis? The muscular movement is carried out, and the portion what is consumed, swallowed, that is sent to the stomach. Now just try to recollect, or actually diagram is not required, because stomach is towards much downside, whereas in between that thoracic cage or chest portion is there, which is having respiratory system. And so whenever we are consuming our food, that is sent through this esophagus till stomach. So what is the role of esophagus? That with help of peristalsis motion, it transfers food from buccopharyngeal cavity. This is buccal chamber and pharynx part. So togetherly we are calling that as buccopharyngeal cavity. So from buccopharyngeal cavity, the food enters in esophagus and ultimately enters in stomach. So role of esophagus is to transfer food from mouth to stomach. Now this is
orthopharyngeal cavity. This is the esophagus. This is thoracic portion. So this is the neck region, then thoracic portion, and it starts with now stomach. Now here walls are there. What is the role of wall? Wall allows flow in one direction. Reverse flow is not allowed, and therefore wherever one consumes food, that enters in stomach. But reverse way from stomach to mouth is not easily possible, except vomiting condition is there. So walls are not 100% rigid. In critical condition, they works in reverse way also, that wherever vomiting is carried out. So this is the first part. Peristalsis motion one can observe over here. In this portion we can observe that peristalsis motion. Now this word peristalsis is very important, because in biology again and again in different system we are using this word as peristalsis. Now when substance enters in stomach, the stomach region is very important. There digestion work is carried out. The first thing, that mixing of different enzymes, that is gastric juice is coming from here. Gastric juice is made up of different part. First, that is mucus secretion is coming now. Mucus means whatever substance present in nose, like that sticky substance is present, that is called as mucus. So this mucus secretion is coming out first, that will line the inside portion of the stomach. The reason is that the whatever digestion process is carried out, enzymes are mixed out, they should not have impact on the walls of stomach. So first part, that digestion process, that mucus is overlying the digestive system, especially in the stomach region, and so the impact of enzymes will not be there on the stomach part. The second thing, the gastric juice comes, that is having hydrochloric acid. You are aware hydrochloric acid is already strong acid, and it is secreted in the stomach region. So second portion important, that is hydrochloric acid. And third, different enzymes like trypsinogen, pepsinogen. So like that enzymes are coming out. Now the inside portion of the stomach is having various projections coming out. If you open out this stomach portion, you will find that something like Turkish towel, the fibers are coming out. So like that parts are present over here, and from that gastric juice comes. Now whatever the food we are consuming out, that is stored in stomach for nearly 3 hours. It is converted into acidified food. The first thing, food is acidified over here. The acidified food is mixed thoroughly. Whatever the crushed down portion of food that is entering in stomach, that is mixed with different enzymes over here. The mixing process is carried out in the stomach. This is working somewhat like mixer. And then after mixing out this thoroughly, that is first thing, in the saliva or mouth portion, the saliva is alkaline in nature. So food is made slightly alkaline first. Then it enters in stomach. It is acidified. Now after approximate 3 hours, it comes out of the stomach here. So this portion is called as duodenum. Duodenum is first part of intestine. The smaller intestine, first part, this is called as duodenum. After that, it enters over here, and in between that, there is one organ. This is called as pancreas. It is associated with another largest gland in our body. This is the liver. So here presence of liver is there. Liver is largest gland in our body, that is associated here. It produces variety of thing, but here with respect to digestive system, we are interested in bile juice. So bile juice is produced over this liver.
and it is stored temporarily in the bladder. This is called as gallbladder. So liver produces out pancreatic juice, liver produces out bile juice that is stored temporarily in gallbladder. Now bile juice is alkaline in nature, basically the waste material, the proteinous waste material that is to be discarded, that is converted into bile juice in liver. Liver is carrying out variety of functions. Out of that, the waste material management is also important. So many times God is giving different uses of the same, or multiple uses are observed. Bile juice, anyway, that is we have to throw away out of the body, but in order to make food alkaline again, it is used here. So bile juice is having deep yellow color, and this is stored in gallbladder. You are aware of jaundice condition, hepatitis A, hepatitis B, whatever you are calling. In that jaundice condition, that bile juice, instead of entering in digestive system, start entering in bloodstream directly, and therefore that yellowness is observed over here. So this is bile juice. It enters here in a duct, and then from pancreas it enters in duodenum via duodenopancreatic duct. In pancreas, a juice is produced that is called as pancreatic juice, which is containing pancreatic amylase. So these are entered over here. That means in duodenum portion, food is made alkaline again. So alkaline, acidic, again alkaline. So HCl is neutralized over here, and the food is made